I'm Drude Dahlerup, and I'm a professor of political science at the University of Stockholm in Sweden. I'm involved in various projects, especially in the Arab countries right now, because the Arab countries are so interesting with the total change, which is an opportunity for women. But there could also be lots of backlash in this. I have a research project with a collaboration between researchers in the Arab world and in the Nordic countries, and another one which is about the getting together of PhD students who study women in public life in the Nordic countries and in the Arab countries, and they are so fantastic nice. So what's the purpose of this? Well, we make conferences in Sweden and in the Arab countries. We just, last 2 days before I came here, we had a conference in Tunisia about regime change and women's political participation. And there is research coming up in the Arab countries on this, very good research also. So what is the next step, I think, is comparative analysis, because usually researchers, they do analysis of your own country. I know my country, and you know very little about the other countries. And I think, especially here in the Arab countries, where you have made new systems, you can share the experience and also the methodology of how to research this on what kind of electoral systems do you have, what kind of quota systems do you have, how does it work with having more women, and et cetera, et cetera. And I think that even to know your own country, you need to know other countries. I also say that to my Swedish students. It's okay, you write about Sweden, but you have to have a good knowledge of other countries to understand how your country works. That's also the only way you can see structures, you can see what is invisible, because if you compare countries, you suddenly see, oh wow, they do this in a different way, or the party system is different, or the electoral system is different, and have different effects. Well, I think the Swedish students, they are very pleased, and they learn a lot by coming and meeting PhD students and master students from the Arab countries, because living in the Scandinavian countries is that you live in countries which have been at peace for a very long time and have what I call the incremental track of development on women's representation, you know, it's kind of step by step by step. And when people ask me, how long time did it take you to get this 40% women in parliament, 42% on the average in the Nordic countries, I have to ask, it took 100 years. We are celebrating women's 100 years for women's suffrage right now. I call that the incremental track model. And then there are in the world, in many parts of the world, especially in post-conflict countries, what you can call a fast-track model. That is, you're not taking this step by step, but you have a situation where you can jump, you can make historical jump in women's representation. Of course, Rwanda is a very good example. Senegal went from 22 to 43% women in one election. We have never tried that in the Scandinavian countries. And so a situation where you have a regime change is an opportunity. And today there's a very much international pressure, and there's international discourse. To be democratic, you have to have gender balance. Algeria is a good example, and this conference is a good example, because this is also about showing that Algeria is the highest in terms of women's representation in the Arab countries, and they're very proud of it. So, and of course we support this, to be proud of this. So there's a new international discourse which can help making these kind of jumps in history. Of course, only if you have also a very, very, very vivid and well-organized women's movement at the grassroots level. So I think that all those very nice international declarations and discourses, and then you have the women's movement, and then you squeeze the dominant politicians and say, okay, we have to change.